Hey guys, I'm LB, and last episode we broke this area even more. We came back with a vengeance, and we have cheated on 3 out of the 4 puzzles here. We also got one of the stars, and we figured out how to get one of the stars, like that one over there from a laser that we elevate over here. Of course, that relies on us actually being able to elevate that laser and solve that puzzle the proper way, as well as solving this puzzle the proper way. So, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do about that. And I can't go in here right now. So I don't even know- oh, that looks like that's where the star is. Well, let's take a look, shall we? But yeah, we cheated our way around and over this wall with 3 boxes. Like, why else would that- yes, the star is here. So that's where the star is, right? Like, it feels like we were actually supposed to break the game. Which is weird. You know, it just seems like weird that they would actually want us to actually break the game. This is too high for us to... yeah. Oh, wow. Okay. Well... I guess we'll have to solve all the 3 puzzles the proper way at a later date. Let's get out of here, shall we? We have 10 stars, right?
Your faith has guided you well, my child. You have overcome every trial in this land, and gathered all the sigils.
Yeah, okay. Where... is the place? Oh, it's over here. So yeah, this is interesting. We can actually do this now, but I'm not sure if it will use up the stars we've gathered or what, because there's other places where we can solve these puzzles. I don't know. Let's use some of our cheaty stars to get this solved, I guess. No, that's not gonna work. That's a bad idea. Thank you. No, that's not gonna work. But that is. So, did that use up all our stars then? And we're not gonna be able to access the other ones? I don't know, let's find out what this is. Everything was kinda grayscale almost. What? Why are these gray? What does this mean? Star, star, 7. This is interesting. Human eye. What is a man's eye but a machine for the little creature that sits behind in his brain to look through? Blah. Is it man's eyes, or is it the big scene engine which has revealed to us the existence of worlds beyond worlds into infinity? What has made the man familiar with the scenery of the moon, the spots on the sun, or the geography of the planets? He is at the mercy of the seeing engine for these things, and is powerless unless he tacks it onto his own identity and make it a part of. And make it a part and parcel of himself. Shouldn't that be makes? Huh. One of the most fascinating aspects of St. Edwald's recently uncovered writings is his preoccupation with finding divine truth in mathematical concepts, which at times borders on pantheism. He was, it would seem, particularly concerned with what we now call tetraminos, seeing in them a reflection of the tetragrammaton and the Greek word for God, Theos. Their ability to form other shapes out of themselves symbolized to him the Creator's ability to reshape the world without breaking the laws he himself had established. Edwald referred to tetraminos as sigils, implying that they were a more truthful version of the magical symbols worshipped by heathens, rooted in both the Abrahamic tradition and careful observation of creation. It is unlikely that these texts were distributed, as they would almost certainly have resulted in charges of hearsay. Yeah, it is cool how the Tetris pieces tend, like, you fit them together and they make another Tetris piece that you don't have. Preservation. I viewed, with a mixture of pity and horror, these beings training to be sold to slaughter, or be slaughtered, and fell into reflections of an old opinion of mine, that it is the preservation of the species, not of individuals, which appears to be the design of the deity throughout the whole of nature. Blossoms come forth only to be blighted, fish lay their spawn where it will be devoured, and what a large portion of the human race are born merely to be swept prematurely away. Blah. Does not this waste of budding life empathetically assert that it is not men, but man, whose preservation is so necessary to the completion of the grand plan of the universe? Children peep into existence, suffer, and die. Men play like moths about a candle and sink into the flame. War and the thousand ills which flesh is heir to, mow them down in shoals, whilst the more cruel prejudices of society pulse existence, introducing not less sure, though slower, decay. That is very weirdly worded. But I guess that is how Old English is, in translations and stuff. What's this one? Image. This is the first time I've seen an image! Star, star, star. It's definitely not star here. So I can view the image again. Interesting. Oh my goodness, how much stuff is out here? Oh, just not very much, I guess. I wonder if we're gonna see any QR codes here. Like, has anybody else made it here? Oh, there's a QR code here. My faith has taken me to the secret place. Here I hope to discover a way of better serving others. Interesting. Nexus. Oh wow. There's a fan over there. What else is in here? Nothing much? Yes, these puzzles require outside thinking. Huh? Oh. Hello there. Is this an or an and? Either way, it looks like it's gonna be a task. So... I have a feeling I know what this box is for. That worked out, strangely enough. Not quite sure how it worked out, but it did. I was expecting it to be a bit more complicated than that, actually. So many ladders. There's that. Interesting. We could also take a box with us if need be. Oh, nope, this works perfectly fine. What the heck is in... Huh? What's the point of all this? What's all this then? What do we need this for again? Remember. How do we even utilize this at all? What is this even for? blazing. A lot of ladders here. This is indeed a Nexus. Oh my goodness, I think I'm getting the idea. Let me start setting this up. Really? It's that simple? What's the point? Yeah, let me move this a little bit closer there real quick. Come on, me up. Yeah, what was the point of that? Interesting. Six. What does six mean? Whoa! Now that is a sight! Is that... It spells Nexus! That is clever! It spells Nexus! What's that over there? Just... generic eye candy, I guess? This is cool. It spells Nexus. How clever. how much can we abuse this? I wonder. Man, this goes so high. No, we can't abuse it very much. It's positioned in just the right way. Yeah, okay. That's cool, I like that. So awesome. What's this little thing? Alright. Unreachable Garden. We can start to explore this one this episode, but we're gonna have to finish it next episode for sure. Ooh, it's a play button. Let's go to a different one. Cobweb. Lots of these guys bouncing around everywhere. That one almost got me. Oh, you jerk. Those guys are gonna be annoying. Anyway, we'll have to figure out how to deal with all these guys in the next episode. So as always, thank you for watching, and if you have to if you hate the sound of my voice, leave a dislike, it's up to you. And I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye!